The following video is dedicated to Thomas Jefferson, a proponent of democracy, republicanism, and individual rights. Jefferson mastered many disciplines, from surveying to mathematics to horticulture and inventions. He described himself as a son of nature. He organized the Louisiana Purchase, which doubled the size of the nation. Jefferson commissioned the Lewis and Clark expedition of the newly acquired territory. He gave detailed instructions on how to keep field journals. This expedition and others that followed it provided critical information for the survival of American pioneers. I highly recommend reading two books, Undaunted Courage by Stephen Ambrose, and The Food Journal by Mary Gunderson. I want to thank my friend Funky Prepper in the UK for gifting me Undaunted Courage. This video is not a reenactment. Instead, I use modern materials when following traditional methods. I'm carrying a spear that's reminiscent of a spontoon, such as the spontoon that Lewis used to kill an attacking grizzly bear. For safety, I put a sheath on the blade. I'm also carrying a bedroll and haversack. This is common to what was carried during the Civil War era. The bedroll includes a wool blanket, bug screen, extra clothing, a lantern, and a tarp. The tarp's on the outside, and it's made from a modern fabric, Cordura, rather than canvas. This is a military surplus haversack, and it contains food and other supplies. In this video, I'll show you a simple way to make English muffins. And I'm making them over a campfire. The recipe is adapted from the Food Journal of Lewis and Clark. Thomas Jefferson described these muffins as a great luxury. Walking is the best possible exercise. Habituate yourself to walking very far. The objective is to relax your mind. I am but a son of nature, loving what I see and feel, without being able to give a reason, nor caring much about whether there be one. In matters of style, swim with the current. In matters of principle, stand like a rock. There is not a sprig of grass that shoots uninteresting to me. This dinner is Thomas Jefferson's favorite meal. Bean soup and muffins, just the way his cook made them. They are, oh, they're scrumptious. You break them apart with a fork and you put butter or honey. I put a little honey on it, and they're all sorts of nooks and crannies. Mmm. They are good. I'm only eating two of the muffins tonight. I'll save the others for breakfast. It sure is a pretty night. The moon's bright enough I can walk around carefully in the dark and not run into things. And the lantern I have here is a little candle, and that's plenty bright enough for me. And anyway, it's probably not gonna get too cold tonight. It's expected to get down to maybe in the high 60s. And so, I'm not sure if I'm going to actually get into the bed. I may just sleep on top of it. I don't think there'll be any insects, but if there are, I've got a bug screen that I can put over me. And so, talk to you guys later. See you in the morning. Good night. Hey, good morning, guys. It's so beautiful. Oh, wow. One travels more usefully when alone, because he reflects more. Pray enable yourself to direct us here how to make muffins in Peter's method. My cook here cannot succeed at all in making them, and they are a great luxury to me. Now you know how to make Thomas Jefferson's favorite muffins. Most Americans today call them English muffins.